beautiful astrology soulmates. It's me, Stormy Grace, and it is time to talk about our upcoming new moon in the ferocious, brave, courageous, well-spirited fire energy of Leo. So this is going to definitely be a moon this month that I think if we look at the astrology available on the chart that I am using via AstroGold on my iPad, we can see that this month has a really nice fire trine going on, although it is loose, but it is still a moon in fire that gives us a time where I think we can actually be very productive in the next 4 weeks. I absolutely love the energy available here. This moon also connects to the north, the south nodes, is in conjunction with Mercury, got a beautiful connection with Mars as well. And the only real big holdup we see kind of squashing the fun a little bit is going to be the Saturn in quincunx to this moon. So I look forward to breaking this down and showing you what we're talking about as we look through the astrology of the new moon in Leo. Now, this moon is coming up August 18th, and it's going to be at 26 degrees and 35 minutes of Leo. Now, the actual astrology that happens when we have a new moon is that we see down here, the sun and the moon are together. They are in conjunction with one another. So when we put our two luminaries together, anything is possible. This is our insides and our outsides, internal, external, absolutely there together. At the new moon phase of the cycle, it's really like pure magic. It is just like anything that you can imagine, you do it. And then you plant those seeds of intention. You know, you plant your seed at this particular phase, but it's the darkest phase. So you really are planting the dream, the vision, the intuition has guided you here at this point. You plant that magic, and then you have to step back and let it grow, let it be cultivated, let it dig in and take root into the soil. So right now we've got the darkest time. In the energy of Leo, what are we looking for? What are we asking for? All Leo things. What's my special sauce, right? Like, what makes me special? What makes me unique? What is my point of view? Where is my joy, right? Where is my play? What do I want to begin? Where is something fun that I'd like to express out into the world, or just what is my voice? So at this particular new moon, that is the question. That is where we're planting the seed of intention at this dark time. What makes you you? What is your unique thing that you have to give to the world, to say, to share, to do, to shine, right? This is a beautiful, beautiful new moon for that. Now, when I'm doing a new moon chart, the first thing that I want to look at is everything that is exact. So we see that this new moon is at 26 degrees, 35 minutes, or close to exact. So the next thing I see that's going to be at 26 degrees, it's going to be the nodes and Saturn. So don't think I forgot about Mercury. I'm going to talk about that as well. But I want to pick out the things that are closest in exactness first. So first things first, we see this big old lunar event happening, right? The new moon is down there. It's lit up, the luminaries, anything's possible. We're asking for what makes me me. What's the voice that I have? What's my self-expression? What's my special sauce? We're putting that though in this really beautiful trine over here to the south node that is in Sagittarius, and a sextile to the north node, which is in Gemini. Now, this south node trine that we've got here, this is a pocket of ease of energy. It's very easy. Now, just because something has been made easy doesn't mean that it's the best thing for us. It doesn't mean it's the worst thing for us. At this particular moon, one of the things we want to be mindful of is, yes, we're looking for what makes you you. And that south node is saying, let's detach, let's move away from something. So this is going to give you a little bit of ease in moving away from some of the things that you thought, or you thought you knew, or have been long ingrained truths for you. Maybe even truths you've had going up here, stories that you've told yourself, and they've become a higher implanted belief that has actually kept you from, you know, speaking your own special sauce. With the ease of this energy, it's actually asking you to move away from that. It's like, yeah, be self-confident. Know yourself. Let's expand this thing out there. Let's take you out. Let's travel. Let's adventure that. But maybe we also have to rethink what we thought we knew before. Let's give this a reinvestigation. Maybe you even have to get back into the depths of looking at the level of your faith. Faith has nothing to do with what you believe. Faith has everything to do with what you're doing. Where are your feet? Are you in motion with these things that are important, that are special to you, that are you? Now, to help that energy, we see that over in that sextile with the North Node in Gemini, now a sextile is beautiful, my friends, because when the planets have sex, that's good for us, because it's not only a pocket of opportunity that's available to you, a pocket of ease, just like that trine, it also is a pocket of ease or opportunity, and you intelligently take action on it. So you're going to use this, right? This is gorgeous, because what it means is, if I have to rethink my faith, I have to rethink how I've been doing things, I have to rethink everything I've thought I've known for a while, or these big truths, maybe big truths, Sagittarius, that have guided my life for a while, and I get to step into this Gemini energy with an opportunity provided to me to learn something else. Learn new information, gather different information, gather something maybe new, maybe new associations with people. Gemini is quite curious. It wants to know what's around, who's around, how do you do that, why do you do that, right? Gemini also is an energy that is very good at going with the flow of ideas. It's an air energy. Now, you put air and fire together, and that is a beautiful energy to expand. So at this particular moon, we see that there is an opportunity for you to expand and gather information that is maybe different than what you knew or what you were working with before, that allows you to express and find and promote who you really are. The other thing I think about that Gemini energy is that Gemini just likes to communicate. This could be a time where it's coming out of your mouth. It's coming out of your fingertips. You are moving forward with that Gemini North Node. It's pulling you forward. It's saying, share, open your mouth. Tell us about you. What do you know? Right? You don't have to be the person who has all of the answers anymore. You can be the student who's also the student learner teacher. You can share with us just what you've already known. The other thing I think about, and I've been talking about this a lot with that North and South node, is that many things for many people, things that you already did in the past, back here, this South Node business back here, you've already done it. You've already seen it. It's already been a part of your life. You've perfected how to do it. Maybe you learned to do it 20 years ago. And today, it's not really, you know, the fire in your basket. You're not really that excited about it anymore. But someone else needs that specific, special to you information for their future to advance. They're learning from you this time. Did you learn to garden 100 years ago? And even if you haven't been outside doing it, you know how to do that and teach that to somebody else. Have you been in a profession for a long time and now you don't have the fire for it, but somebody else wants to get into that profession and you can show them how to do it? And there's this beautiful dichotomy, I think, that happens too, especially around work or mundane things like at home, where you feel like, oh, it's just the same old, same old. And as soon as you start talking or teaching someone else about it, you get this fire. You get the fire that this grand trine, I think, promises you for the next 4 weeks. And it's like, that's right, I am good at, or, oh, that's right, I know how to do this, or that's right, I'm done with this now, but you can have it. And either way, it does what fire does for us. It inspires, it moves, it brings heat, it brings a vitality and an energy to us. And I think everybody could use that at this point in the year. This is a beautiful moon cycle. Now, where's the hold up, right? Hold up, wait. Okay, some of you will know what that is. Either way, we see at 26 degrees, we have also got this quincunx with Saturn, who's up here retrograde. Okay, now the quincunx is the aspect of adjustment. I'm adjusting over and over again. So I'm down here in the new moon planting my seeds of intention of me. This is my special thing I have to offer. This is my special thing that I have to say. But it hits this quincunx, this adjustment, with Saturn, who's up here in Capricorn in retrograde. Now, Saturn retrograde in Capricorn is, first of all, remember, taking you back to something you've already seen. You've already been working on this for a couple years. Saturn has been trying to bring mastery for you in this area. He's been telling you, you got to grow up. We have to get serious. We have to really come to another level with this information. We have to come to another level in this area of our life. It's very much so a maturing energy. Now, in retrograde, he's going back over these lessons you've been learning at that particular aspect and at that particular degree for the last couple years. So Saturn is up here double checking your work, making sure you got it right, you understand what's going on, and probably he's nodding his head going, yeah, good job, good on you. And then you've got this moon down here saying, you're right, I'm ready to go, let's do it right now. But these two don't quite understand each other, because while Saturn, I think, is proud of the work that you've done, he's also saying, well, wait a minute, there's still some restrictions. There's still some limitations. We've got to do some adjusting here. So really, when I boil this down, instead of Saturn stepping in here with this quincunx, bringing a full stop, bringing just the walls up, we can't go any further, I think what it asks you to do is take whatever it is that you want to do, you want to put out in the world, and I want you to break it down to size. Saturn saying, that cake is too big to eat all at once. Let's break it down to size, because in this quincunx, the adjustment is, I'm trying to understand what you're doing. A quincunx is happening here between an earth energy that is grounded, wants structure, wants success. It is quincunxing a fire energy that's like, let's do it, let's go, I'm ready, let's move, right? Even their qualities don't match. We've got a cardinal and a fixed, so they're trying to understand how to work with one another. So the adjustment you can make here is take whatever plan, whatever you're thinking is you, whatever you're wanting to do and put out there in the world, and break it down into smaller pieces, into size. Just days after this happens, we move into Virgo energy, which will again help break everything that you're trying to do down into individual steps. Saturn here is also going to make you double check. Did you do the work? Are you solid? Are you steady? Do you have something prepared, or are you getting something prepared enough that you can actually stand on it and be successful? Because what Saturn has no interest in doing is just letting you fly out of the gate with something you think is a great idea and it's not grounded enough that it's to your greatest good. So I think that we also run up against a little bit of energy here that can feel frustrating, because it's like, am I really ready? Am I really ready to take that thing out of there? But that is a practical earth sign question. In your material world, in your material space, do you have a solid foundation? The other part of, am I ready? Can I do this? That we would see in this nodal work, which could just be stuff about beliefs in your head. Just because you're thinking it doesn't mean it's the truth, right? So as you bump up against the Saturn energy, just ask yourself in the material plane, is this thing ready to go? Now, speaking of bonking up against the head, I told you I did not forget that Mercury's hanging out over here in conjunction with this moon as well. Now, what this again brings back to me is the theme that there's a lot of stuff that's happening in the mind and in the mouth, in the mind and how we communicate, how we perceive information, how we put it out there at this particular moon. Mercury being in conjunction here, Mercury in Leo, I call that fire in the mouth, right? It's fire in the mouth. It's, the self-expression is available here. It is busy thinking. Anytime Mercury gets near the sun, the mind gets busy, the conversation gets busy, the things around us get a little bit busy, and they're all meeting in a fire energy. This is a busy moon, but it is also a superb moon to look at your thinking. It is a good moon to look at what's coming out of your mouth. What are you talking about, right? This is a beautiful time that I think too, with that connection to that south node energy up here, you guys, to think about, why do you believe what you believe? Why are you saying what you're saying? Where does that belief come from? Is it true? Is it outdated? Mercury is here looking, helping you search your mind, search your you for what's really you. or what's been given to you that you're spouting off out there in any capacity, and that's not actually your belief structure anymore. So Mercury is acting as a beautiful, happy helper here. Now, Sun, Moon, Mercury, they're all trine. They all are going to put some emphasis on that new learning with that North Node as well. Now, let's look at the other side of this, because we've got Mars over here also bringing in a really sexy trine here. Mars over here at 24 degrees in Aries. Now, something to consider. Mars at the time of this moon is, of course, not retrograde yet, but he is in shadow, so he is slowed down in his home sign. Now, why do you care about that? That is brilliant, because Mars in Aries, he's pumped, he's powered, he's ready to go. Let's do this is absolutely what's going on there. But as Mars slows down in Aries, he's slowed down a little bit. That's like, yeah, let's absolutely do this. But also, who planted these roses here, right? You get to stop and realize that in a slower pace of a very efficient Mars, that you can look around and see what else is out there, right? Oh man, I've never really stopped to think about how that impacts my identity. I've never really had enough energy to stop and think about how me not sharing myself impacts my identity, right? Now, Mars also here, just Mars in a trine with a moon, is our indicator that this can be a very productive moon. This can be a very productive, fiery 4 weeks for you that you can really get. It's just really superb. So try and be in action as much as you can. Don't push against Saturn. Saturn's asking you to adjust. So don't push too hard. Now, across the way, we see that to complete this grand trine that we've got going, a grand trine in fire, a big old pocket of opportunity to be highly productive in the next coming weeks is absolutely available to you. And I love, love, love that energy for us, you guys. That is a big old opportunity. But again, I point out, Saturn driving through here is going to ask you to double check your work, because it's not entirely clear on what's going on. Now, as we get just a day later, we're going to see Mercury moving into the energy of Virgo, where it's very at home and comfortable. So when I tell you to, with that Saturn energy, whatever you're feeling like is your special thing to put out there, Mercury in Virgo is going to help you bring it down to size as well. It's going to say, step by step, let's do this, let's do this, let's do this, right? It's going to bring each and every single one of those things down to scale for you. So any passion projects, anything you're trying to initiate, you're going to have some helpers there. Now, Leo is a fixed energy. So I also want to just take a look at what our other fixed energy is doing in this particular chart. And we've got Taurus, okay? So we've got Uranus over here in Taurus, who's in an absolutely lovely sextile with Venus. Okay, now the planets are having sex, so that is good for us. It's a pocket of opportunity that you will also meet with some excellent action. Now, Uranus in Taurus is already shaking up a fixed sign. So it's shaking foundation. It's shaking what has already been. Okay. Now, Venus in Cancer is saying, I want to nurture. I would love to nurture relationships. I would love to nurture money. I would love to nurture home. I would love to nurture myself. I would love to nurture. This is the first home we have. I would love to nurture my family, my heart, my roots. Okay. So as these two are in this really excellent sextile together, I think that there is just this really sexy kind of light and creative energy that is coming into how you're going to nourish and reinvent yourself. How are you going to nourish and reinvent home and your foundations? And remember, I told you some of the things you've got are back here in your basket already. You've already used these. You know these so well. How can you bring them out and bring them forward and make them valuable in some way in your life, or valuable for someone else? This sextile brings a lot of delicious opportunity. Uranus is also a very social energy. And Taurus and Cancer do like being together. So maybe it's a great time in this next couple weeks to get together with a grouping of people and eat and talk and laugh and express and be inspired by what's going on and let the ideas and let the food and let the delicious and the joy and the play surround you. But enjoy the conversation and ideas that I think are abundant and available for us at this particular moon. Uranus in Taurus, and he's retrograde as well. So it tells me you're going back to a foundational piece of you, something you have already done. You've already had your hands in the dirt with this already. And now with this new moon, it brings you an opportunity to bring it forward in some new inspired way. So I think it's going to be a beautiful moon. And I would also ask you, in true connection with the cycles, when you look back to what happened at our previous full moon that was happening in Aquarius, that was shaking up friendships, social groups, organizations, any of the social places, the place of what you do to add to the whole, what you have to do for freedom. That was a big question at that particular full moon. What do you got to do? What do you need to adjust in your perspective? Perspective for freedom? And now that you've seen it, are you prepared to step the you that is really you out into that in some way, shape, or form? One last thing I just want to leave this with, given the current climate out in the world, okay? A couple of these placements, especially in high fire, can put us in a position where it's like mine is the only right opinion. And it would really, I don't think any of you would do that because you're brilliant. But if you do find yourself there thinking, I am the only one that has the answer, or there's only one way to do this, there's only one answer for this, there's only one candidate that could do this, any of those kinds of one way thoughts, I would ask you to use this moon to investigate and to be inspired to not only share, but listen to what's being shared with you as well. All right, my beautiful friends, I hope that this finds you so well. Like this video, comment, share, subscribe. I look forward to seeing you in the Eat and Greets. The September videos and the October videos will actually be out a little bit earlier because, you know, once we get to the second half of the year, we got to start getting ready for 2021 as well. So I hope all of that is engaging and guiding and beautiful for you. I love you so much, and I look forward to seeing you in our next video. Bye, everyone.